Good morning students, welcome back to Max class. We'll continue with the same exercise. Fourth question. Meena went to a bank to withdraw rupees 2000. She asked the cashier to give her rupees 50 and rupees 100 notes only. Meena got 25 notes in all. Find how many notes of rupees 50 and rupees 100 she received. So she went to a bank to withdraw 2000 rupees. And she asked the cashier to give her only 50 rupee note and 100 rupee note. She got 25 notes together. Find how many notes of 50 rupee and 100 rupee she received. So how can we start the sum? Let the number of 50 rupee note be x and number of 100 rupee note be y. Let the number of 50 rupee note be x and 100 rupee note be y. Total how many notes she got? 25 notes she got. So x number of 50 rupees and y number of 100 rupees, together she got 25 notes. So x plus y is equal to 25. This is our first equation. X number of 50 rupee notes and y number of 100 rupee notes, together 25 notes she got. Next, she asked the cashier, she want only 50 rupee note and 100 rupee notes, and totally she had taken 2000 rupees. So 50 rupees she want x number of notes. So 50x and 100 rupees y number of notes. So 100y. So 50 rupee note x number plus y number 100 rupee note, together she got 2000 rupees. And this is our second equation. This equation we can simplify by dividing by 50. 50 by 50, it is 1x. 52 is 100, so it is 2y. 2000 by 50, 54 is 200, so 1040. This is our second equation. So again, I'll repeat. She had taken x number of 50 rupee note and y number of 100 rupee note. Totally 25 note she got. Next, she asked, she want only 50 and 100 rupees. So 50x, if the number of 50 rupee note is 10, we will say 50 into 10. Similarly, 50 into x plus 100 rupee note in y in number, 100y, together she got 2000 rupees. So divide by 50, this equation will get x plus 2y is equal to 40. Now we will simplify these two equations by elimination method. We will write the equation together. X plus y is equal to 25, equation 1. X plus 2y is equal to 40, equation 2. Here, coefficient of x is same and both of them are positive in sign. We will subtract the equation. While subtracting, we have to change the sign. So everywhere we have to change the sign. X and x cancelled. 1y minus 2y, it is minus y. 25 minus 40, minus 50. Both the minus will cancel. We'll get y is equal to 50. Now we will find the value of x. Substitute the value of y in equation 1. So x plus y is equal to 25. X plus 50 is equal to 25. X is equal to 25 minus 15 is equal to 10. So x is 10 and y is 50. So how many 50 rupee note? X number of 50 rupee notes. Therefore, number of 50 notes equals 10. And number of 100 rupee notes equals 50. 10 plus 15, totally 25 notes. The fifth question. A lending library has a fixed charge for the first 3 days and an additional charge for each day thereafter. Sarita paid 27 for a book kept for 7 days while Susie paid rupees 21 for the book she kept for 5 days. Find the fixed charge and the charge for each extra day. So a library has a fixed charge for the first 3 days and an additional charge for each day thereafter. So we wanted to find the fixed charge and the charge for extra day, that is the additional charge. So we will start the sum. Like, let the fixed charge be rupees X. Let the fixed charge be rupees X and the additional charge per day or for 1 day be Y. Be rupees Y. Fixed charge will consider as X and for each day additional charge will be considered as rupees Y. Now we will see the question. Sarita paid rupees 27 for a book kept for 7 days. So she had kept the book for 7 days. In the 7 days, for 3 days, first 3 days, there is a fixed charge. So this 7 can be split as 3 plus 4. So totally she kept the book for 7 days. 3 days, there is a fixed charge. Next 4 days, each day, additional charge will be paid. So how can we write the first equation? So for 3 days, X rupees. So 3 days it is X rupees, that is the fixed charge, plus 4 days for each day Y rupees. So for 1 day Y rupees means for 4 days how much rupees? It is 4Y. So X plus 4Y is equal to how much she paid? She paid 27 rupees. So for the fixed 3 days, fixed charge for 3 days, this is for X rupees, and for the next each number of days the charge will be Y rupees. So if 1 day Y rupees means she kept extra 4 days, so 4 into Y is equal to 27. This is our equation number 1. Now the second sentence, while Susie paid rupees 21 for the book she kept for 5 days. So she kept it for 5 days. This 5 can be written as 3 plus 2. 3 days fixed charge. So that is X rupees. For the remaining 2 days, each day Y rupees. So for 1 day Y rupees means 2 days it is 2Y. And she paid totally 21 rupees. And this is our second equation. So now we will solve this equation. Equation 1 and equation 2. We will subtract 1 minus 2. Change the sign. X and X cancel, 2Y is equal to 6, Y is equal to 6 by 2, 3. So Y we got. Now we will find the value of X. Second equation, right? X plus 2Y is equal to 21, X plus 2 into 3 equals 21, X plus 6 equals 21, X equals 21 minus 6 is equal to 15. So X is 15 and Y is 3. Now, therefore, the fixed charge equals, that we have taken as X rupees, that is 15 rupees. So for 3 days, fixed charge is 15 rupees and additional charge for per day. Additional charge for 1 day or for per day is Y rupees and that is 3 rupees. So each day extra 3 rupees. So 15 and 3. Now we will move on to the next exercise. Exercise 3.5. Which of the following pairs of linear equation has unique solution, no solution or infinitely many solutions? In case there is a unique solution, find it by using cross multiplication method. Since cross multiplication method is not included this year, so we will solve these sums using elimination method. So the first question is x minus 3y minus 3 equals 0, 3x minus 9y minus 2 equals 0. First we have to check whether unique solution or no solution or many solutions. If unique solution, we have to solve the equation. So to check whether unique solution or no solution, we have to find the ratio. The formula is A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2, we should find out and see the ratio. A1 by A2 is equal to coefficient of x. For the first equation, it is 1 by 3. B1 by B2 is equal to -3 by -9. Again, it becomes 1 by 3. C1 by C2 is equal to -3 by -2. So here, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2. If the ratio is like this, we know that there is no solution. Question: 2x plus y equals 5, 3x plus 2y is equal to 8. Before finding the ratio, we have to take all the terms to the left side and write it in the standard form. So 2x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0, and 3x plus 2y minus 8 is equal to 0. First, a1 by a2 is equal to 2 by 3. B1 by B2 is equal to B1, it is 1, here it is 2. See, A1 by A2 is 2 by 3 and B1 by B2 is 1 by 2. A1 by A2 not equal to B1 by B2. So in this case, no need to check what is C1 by C2. We can write unique solution. Unique solution. So if it is unique solution, we have to find the values of x and y. We have to solve this equation. So we will consider the first equation, 2x plus y is equal to 5. Second equation, 3x plus 2y is equal to 8. Now you see, here it is 1y and here it is 2y. We will multiply the first equation by 2 so that y becomes 2y. So first equation, multiply by 2. 2 into 2x, 4x plus 2 into y, 2y. Is equal to 2 into 5, 10. First equation. Now, second equation we will write as it is. 3x plus 2y is equal to 8. This is our second equation. As both have same sign, we'll subtract the equation. Subtracting time, change the sign. 4x minus 3x, it is x. 2y cancel. 10 minus 8, it is 2. So the value of x is 2. Now, substitute the value of x in first equation. We will get the value of y. So 2 into 2 plus y is equal to 5. 4 plus y is equal to 5. Y is equal to 5 minus 4 equals 1. So the solution is x is 2 and y is 1. Third question. 3x minus 5y equals 20. 6x minus 10y equals 40. Again, we will write 3x minus 5y minus 20 equals 0 and 6x minus 10y minus 40 equals 0. A1 by A2 equals 3 by 6 equals 1 by 2. B1 by B2 equals minus 5 by minus 10 is equal to 1 by 2. C1 by C2 equals minus 20 by minus 40 is equal to 1 by 2. Cancel 0, 0, 2 and 4, you get 1 by 2. All the three ratios are equal. Therefore, what about the solution? Infinite number of solutions. So, only in the case where a unique solution will find the value of x and y. Second question. For which value of a and b does the following pair of linear equation have an infinite number of solutions? First question, in second main there are two sums. The first question, 2x plus 3y equals 7, a minus b into x plus a plus b into y equals 3a plus b minus 2. Here we have to find the value of a and b in which the pair of linear equation have infinite number of solutions. So, infinite number of solution means the ratio should be A1 by A2 should be equal to B1 by B2 and that is equal to C1 by C2. This is the condition for infinite number of solutions. So, here what is A1? A1 is 2, B1 is 3. C1, we have to take it to the left side. It becomes minus 7. Same way, A2. A2 is the coefficient of x in the second equation. That is A minus B. B2 is A plus B. And C2 is the whole term. There are three terms. It's a trinomial. All these terms, when we take it to the left side, all the terms will become negative. Means sign will change. So, we'll take one common sign and we'll write it in bracket. So, here when we write, this is minus 7 is equal to 0. And here minus 7 in bracket we have to write equal to 0. Because this sign will be for all the terms. So, I put the bracket. Now, we will write the ratio. A1 by A2. It is 2 by A minus B equals B1 by B2. 3 by A plus B equals C1 by C2 is minus 7 by minus 3A plus B minus 2. So, we have written the ratio. We have to find the value of A and B. So, as we have three values, three fractions, at a time we cannot solve it with all the three fractions or three terms. We have to compare any two terms. So, first two fractions we will consider in the first case. So, once again I will write 2 by A minus B is equal to 3 by A plus B. Now, we will cross multiply. 2 into A plus B is equal to 3 into A minus B. 2A plus 2B is equal to 3A minus 3B. We will take all the terms to the left side. 2A plus 2B minus 3A plus 3B is equal to 0. 2A minus 3A, this minus A. 2B plus 3B, this 5B is equal to 0. This is equation 1. Similarly, we have to find one more equation. First case, we compare these two. We have taken and we got the equation. In the second case, we can compare the first and last. We can equate or the second and the last. So, I will take first fraction and the last fraction. Together, we will take 2 by A minus B is equal to, this minus and minus we can cancel, 7 by 3a plus b minus 2. Now we will cross multiply. 2 into 3a plus b minus 2 is equal to 7 into a minus b. 2 into 3a, 6a plus 2 into b, 2b, 2 into 2, 4 equals 7a minus 7b. We will take these A and B terms to the left side and the constant to the right side. So, 6A plus 2B minus 7A plus 7B is equal to constant term, we will take it to the right side. 6A minus 7A, this minus A, 2B plus 7B plus 9B is equal to 4. This is our second equation. Now, through elimination method, we will find the value of A and B. So, now look here, the first equation minus A, for the second equation also minus A, same coefficient, directly we will write and subtract the equation. Minus A plus 5B equals 0, first equation. Second equation is minus A plus 9B equals 4. We will subtract the equation, while subtracting we have to change the sign. So, minus A plus A will cancel. 5b minus 9b minus 4b, 0 minus 4 minus 4, minus minus cancel, b is equal to 4 by 4 is equal to 1. So, the value of b is 1. To find the value of a, first equation I'll write, minus a plus 5b equals 0, minus a plus 5 into 1 equals 0, minus a plus 5 equals 0, minus A equals minus 5, A is equal to 5. So, the value of A is 5 and the value of B is 1 if it has infinite number of solutions. Next question, for which value of K will the following pair of linear equations have no solution? So, the equations are 3x plus y equals 1 and 2k minus 1 into x plus k minus 1 into y equals 2k plus 1. No solution means the formula is A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 not equal to C1 by C2. No solution. So, So here we should find only one variable, that is k. So we will write here a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, not equal to c1 by c2. We'll write the values 3 by 2k minus 1 is equal to y. Coefficient is 1. Here the coefficient is k minus 1 is equal to, here we will take 1 to the left side, so it is minus 1, and here it is minus of 2k plus 1. It is not equal to, we will write. Now, as we have value k here, we want to find the value of k, only we will equate the first two ratios. No need to go for the third one. So, we once again will write 3 by 2k minus 1 is equal to 1 by k minus 1. Cross multiply, 3 into k minus 1 is equal to 1 into 2k minus 1. 3k minus 3 is equal to 2k minus 1. 3k minus 2k is equal to minus 1 plus 3. K is equal to 2. So, if it has no solution, then the value of K is 2. Say 2 mark question. Third question. Solve the following pair of linear equation by the substitution and cross multiplication method. We'll change it into elimination method. So, we will solve this equation by elimination method. Now, here you see A8 and 3 are the coefficients of X. And here 5 and 2 are the coefficients of y. All the terms are different. So what we have to do to change it into the same number? Either we have to convert 8 and 3 into same number. Means coefficient of x should become same, or the coefficient of y we can make it into same. So I will change y coefficient. For that, first equation I will multiply by 2. So what is 5 into 2? We will get 10 here. So second equation we have to multiply 2 with 5. Then only we will get 10 here. Either x or y coefficient, we will make it same. So 1 into 2. First equation into 2. 8 2s are 16x plus 10y is equal to 18 we will get. Second equation we will multiply by 5. 5 into 3, 15x plus again 10y is equal to 20 we will get. So as same sign, will subtract the equation. Change the sign. Equation 1 minus equation 2, 16x minus 15x, it is x, y cancelled, 18 minus 20 minus 2. The value of x is minus 2. Now, write any one of the equation, substitute the value of x and find the value of y. So, 3 into minus 2 plus 2y is equal to 4. Minus 6 plus 2y is equal to 4. 2y equals 4 plus 6, 10. Y equals 10 by 2, 5. So the value of y is 5 and x is minus 2. So when the numbers are different in both the case, any one we can convert into the same. The next question. Form the pair of linear equation in the following problems and find the solution by any algebraic method. So we will do in elimination method. So the first question is, a part of monthly hostel charges is fixed and the remaining depends on the number of days one has to take food in the mess. When a student A takes food for 20 days, she has to pay rupees 1000 as hostel charges, whereas a student B who takes food for 26 days pays rupees 1180 as hostel charges. Find the fixed charge and the cost for food per day. So we will start the sum. As let the fixed charge be rupees x. Let the fixed charge be rupees x and charge for cost of food per day and cost for food per day or one day be rupees. So now, fixed charge, a part of monthly hostel charges is fixed and the remaining depends on the number of days one has to take food in the mess. So first starting it is fixed charge and y is depends on how many days the child has taken food from the mess. So when a student A takes food for 20 days, she has to pay 1000 rupees. So how can we write the equation? So, she will be taking 20 days food from the mess. So, So first x is the fixed charge and per day y rupees for food. So 20 days she had taken the food. So 20 y, and the charges will be 1000 for her. The first child. The second child who takes food for 26 days and the charge is 1180. So first fixed charge, she had taken 26 days food. So 26 y is equal to 1180, equation number 2. Now directly we can subtract the equation. Equation 1 minus equation 2. Change the sign. X will cancel. Minus 6y is equal to minus 180. Minus and minus will cancel. Y is equal to 180 by 6, 30. So y equals 30. To find the value of x, substitute the value of y in any one of the equations. So 20y is equal to 1000. X plus 20 into 30 is equal to 1000. X plus 600 is equal to 1000. X equals 1000 minus 600. It is 400. Therefore, the fixed charge equals x. So what is the fixed charge? It is 400 rupees. And cost for food per day. So 1 day. For 1 day. Equals rupees y. That is 30 rupees. So 30 rupees per day for food. And the fixed charge is 400. Third question. Sorry, second question. A fraction becomes 1 by 3 when 1 is subtracted from the numerator and it becomes 1 by 4 when 8 is added to the denominator. Find the fraction. So, let the fraction be x by y. Let the fraction be x by y. This type of question carries 3 mark. So, it becomes 1 by 3. This fraction becomes 1 by 3 when 1 is subtracted from the numerator. 1 is subtracted from the numerator. So now we will simplify the equation. Cross multiply. 3 into x minus 1 is equal to y. 3x minus 3 is equal to y. We will take y to the left side. 3x minus y is equal to plus 3. This is equation 1. Now, the second sentence, and it becomes 1 by 4. The fractions become 1 by 4 when 8 is added to its denominator. So, we will add 8 to the denominator. The fraction becomes 1 by 4. So, now we cross multiply. 4x is equal to y plus 8. Or 4x minus y is equal to 8. This is equation 2. So the first equation is 3x minus y is equal to 3. Second equation is 4x minus y is equal to 8. We'll subtract the equation 1 minus 2. Change the sign. 3x minus 4x, it is minus x. Y cancel. 3 minus 8 minus 5. X is equal to 5. Now we'll find the value of y. 3x minus y is equal to 3. 3 into 5 minus y is equal to 3. 15. 3 will bring it to this side. Y equals 12. So the fraction is x by y. And x is 5. Y is 12. 5 by 12. The fraction is 5 by 12. Third question. Yash scored 40 marks in a test, getting 3 marks for each right answer and losing 1 mark for each wrong answer. Had 4 marks been awarded for each correct answer and 2 marks been deducted for each wrong answer or incorrect answer, then Yash would have scored 50 marks. How many questions were there in the test? So here we should find out total questions in the test in which S scored 40 marks in a test, getting 3 marks for each right answer. So, how can we write the first question? Let the number of right answer be X. Let the number of right answers be X and the number of wrong answers be Y. So we want to find out total number of questions in the test. So first the boy scored 40 marks. He got 40 marks in a test by writing, getting 3 marks for each right answer. If there are X number of right answers and for one right answer 3 marks, means total how much mark he will get? 3x mark. For one right answer, he will get 3 mark. There are x right answers. For example, if there are 10 answers is correct, 3 into 10, 30 mark. Like that, 3x. And he made 1 mark for each wrong answer. So, wrong answer means the sign will be negative. So, wrong answer number is y. So, if each wrong answer, he will be losing 1 mark. So, how many wrong answers? Y wrong answers. So, it is 1y. So, as he is losing, it is minus. 3x minus 1y is equal to 40. Let me repeat once again. In his exam, he had written x number of correct answers and y number of wrong answers. Each correct answer, he will be getting 3 mark and each wrong answer, he will be losing 1 mark. So, as he has written x number of correct answers, 3 into x number of correct answers, and as he has written y number of wrong, and for each wrong answer 1 mark he is losing, 1y, 3x minus 1y is equal to 40. This is our first equation. Now the second statement says that if he had 4 mark being awarded for each correct answer, if the correct answer, if it is 4 mark, then what we will write? 4x, because x number of correct answers. And if he lose 2 mark being deducted for each incorrect answer. So, losing 2 mark for each wrong answer means it is 2y. You would have got 50 mark. So, is equal to 50. This is our second equation. I hope you understood this. So, 3x minus 1y is equal to 40. 4x minus 2y is equal to 50. So, here it is 1y. We will multiply the first equation by 2. So that 6x minus 2y is equal to 80. We will write this as first equation. Second equation as it is we will write. And we will subtract the two equations by changing the sign. Equation 1 minus equation 2. Why we are writing this? Because if you are not writing this, sometimes here we will subtract, suddenly here we will add. So always write this. 6x minus 4x, 2x. Y terms cancel. 80 minus 50, it is 30. X is equal to 30 by 2, it is 50. So now we should find the value of y. First equation I'll write. 3x minus y is equal to 40. 3 into 15 minus y is equal to 40. 45 minus y is equal to 40. 45 minus 40 is equal to y. Therefore, y is equal to 5. What is the meaning? X is equal to 15 and y is equal to 5. He had written 15 correct answers and 5 wrong answers. Number of right answers is 15. Number of right answers or correct answers is 15. And number of wrong answers is 5. Wrong answers is 5. So, for him, 15 correct answer and 5 wrong answer. Then how many number of questions, total number of questions in the test is? Total questions equals 15 plus 5, 20. Total number of questions in the test is 20. That's all for today's class. Thank you.